Today we're going to have some fun creating a gooey slime effect with some custom type. You could apply this to your own hand lettering pieces, but I'm going to be using a ready-made font, which I'll be customising with the vector drip shapes. Once the outline is complete, we'll then add some bright colours to make the ooze radioactive, then use a simple trick with the brush tool to add some highlights. So open up Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. Begin by typing out your wording using a bold cursive font with nice fat curves. I'm using a premium typeface named Number 7. This particular font has lots of alternate characters that can be used to completely customise the appearance. I liked one of the stylistic S glyphs, but flipped the other way up. To do this, the text element has to be outlined, then ungrouped to break the letters apart in order to manipulate the size, rotation and position of that one character. Once you have your text in place, go to Object Envelope Distort and Make with Warp. Choose Arc at 15% to give it a subtle bend, then rotate it slightly. Go to Objects and Expand to permanently apply this Envelope Distort effect. Now we're ready to customise the type with gooey drips. Double click the pencil tool to edit its settings. Max out the Fidelity slider to Smooth, then make sure Fill New Pencil Strokes is checked, along with Keep Selected and Edit Selected Paths. Zoom right into the first letter and draw the outline of a drip. The process is a little easier with a pen tablet, but the smoothing of the pencil tool corrects any mistakes you might make. Since we have the Keep Selected and Edit Selected Paths settings checked, you can redraw over any outlines that don't look right to try again. If you find the pencil tool is a bit awkward, here's a couple of other techniques you might want to try. First one is the pen tool, so rather than freehand draw the outline, you click and drag the bezier handles to create those smooth curves. Alternatively, you could just roughly draw the outline using straight lines and corners, then go to Effects, Stylize and Round Corners. Bump up the radius until those angles are converted to smooth lines. Whichever method you choose, draw a variety of drip lengths and shapes all over the letters. In some areas, you can even add gooey stringy bits between two parts of the letter shape. Also, try adding some double drips too. They help fill out some space. Don't worry about them flowing into the letters perfectly just yet. We'll carefully blend them next. Once you have all your drips in place, head back to the first letter and zoom in. Turn on Smart Guides from under the View menu, which will help you to snap to the existing path lines. Use the pencil to draw little shapes that smooth off any angles in the outline by adding a bezier curve to bridge the gap. The rest of the path can be really rough. It won't be visible being black on black. Once all the drips have been blended in, a few simple ellipses can be a great finishing touch to add some extra drips on the end of those droopy bits. Draw a selection across all the artwork and make a copy if you want to preserve an editable version. Otherwise, click the Unite button in the Pathfinder panel to merge everything into one outline. Now you can change the fill to represent whatever kind of sticky substance you want your text to be made from, whether it's slime, snot, chocolate sauce, or whatever viscous fluid you fancy. To add some depth to the effect, add an inner glow from the Effects and Stylize menu. Change the settings to white with the overlay mode so the same glow effect will still work if you change the base fill colour, then reduce the opacity to 50% and set the blur to 10 pixels. To add some highlight lines, we first need a little tool to use. Draw a small circle somewhere on the artboard, then use the Direct Selection tool to drag each side point outwards while holding the Shift key. Change the fill to white, then click the new brush icon in the brushes panel and select Art Brush. Alter the colorization drop down to tints if you want the option to change the brush color later, then hit OK. You can delete that temporary shape we used to create the brush. Set up the appearance options as a white stroke with no fill, then use the pen tool to draw a series of short curved lines that follow the outline of the text. Create them in places where a little specular highlight would appear. Click any of the lines with the Magic Wand tool to automatically select them all, then apply the brush we just created. The sizing might need to be adjusted by altering the stroke weight, then change the blending mode to Soft Light. Go to Effect, Blur and Gaussian Blur, then enter 2 pixels to give the highlights a softer appearance. Draw a large rectangle across the entire type design, filled with a colour of your choice that complements your text, then right click and select Arrange Center Back to use it as a background. The final result is a gloopy slime effect that can be used to create custom type for logos and lettering pieces. If you enjoyed this tutorial or learnt anything new, be sure to subscribe to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel to stick around for all my upcoming videos. Visit my website at spoon.graphics if you fancy getting your sticky fingers on some free design resources. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.